In this tutorial series, we're going to learn how to fully control and render toon lines in Flair for Maya. Hopefully, by the end of it, you can replace whatever you're using in favor of Flair. I'm Henriette from Artineering, and we develop artist-driven tools for stylized rendering. Let's get started. To use toon lines in Flair for Maya, we first need to set the correct shader style. The easiest way to do so is by using the style presets, which can be opened from the Flair shelf by clicking on the style icon. This will open up the style presets window. You can learn all about using and saving the style presets through the links in the description below. For now, we're just going to select and load the lines preset. Once loaded, you will automatically start seeing lines on the object in your scene. That's it! Tutorial series done!
Wait, what? What did I work months for?
It's okay, I'll do it. Alright, so this tutorial series covers everything there is to do in Flair to control and art direct toon lines to fit your desired style. In the first tutorial, we learn how to control the line intensity and art direct the line width globally or locally on specific parts of objects. Then we go into controlling the line width based on the object's distance to the camera so that the lines get wider or thinner according to their depth. Then it's time to add color, either based on the object's color, a custom global color, or the lighting around them, or all of these combined. You can further art direct color locally in specific parts of objects. If you like what we will cover, give us a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to our channel with a bell icon to be notified about future tutorials like this one. Back to the overview. Sometimes you will want to erase or draw inlines, so we will also teach you how to erase or draw toon lines wherever they're needed. But before you go all out Picasso on your scene, we will teach you how to optimize model and texture details and fine-tune thresholds to generate the best possible edges out of the box. Finally, we will cover how to render these lines and their AUVs so that you can take them to compositing for further pixel pushing and even merge them with renderers outside of Flair. There's a lot to cover, so buckle up and let's flare some lines. If you love what we're doing, make sure to purchase a commercial license or become our Patreon to use Flair without resolution limitations and have your name appear in this beautiful list of credits. Flare you on the next one!